All right, this is my first Let's Play video. I'm here with WootRocket here. He's my assassin bro. And then me is, what am I, commando? Anyway.
Yes, sir.
We're going to try to do some Let's Play, so let's play, whatever. You lead.
Okay, well, we are very new to this whole experience, so we're going to be extremely awkward probably, so expect it, and hopefully we'll get some laughs out of it. Okay, so basically what we're going to do now is we're going to go... Wait, let me see what this guy wants.
Protection from bullets, ho!
Oh, we had... we just finished a job that we started last night.
Would you like to do battle with a midget riding piggyback on a bullymong? If the answer is yes, please proceed to the southern shelf and defeat Midgemong for me. If the answer is no, you are sad and I have no desire to speak with you further.
Alright, do this. Kill a midget riding a bullymong. So what do you got equipped right now? Anything delightful? I haven't found any good guns yet, though.
I have my...
All my guns are...
Rifle.
Yeah. I think we have the same exact gun. This game's weird that it gives you the same guns for completing quests and whatever.
I still think that is the grossest thing ever.
For all the items. My experience with this boss is that he's a pain in the ass at our level. When you first tried to run through, oh, you're down.
It's okay, I'll be okay. I lied, maybe not.
Fire! I'm out of ammo. I like how they program the AI in the game to fight the natural wildlife before you. Person, like, effectively slaughtering both of them.
Yeah, that'd be super fun.
We are victorious. And I have found a gun. Which looks like it's crap.
Yep. Whatever. Sell it or something.
Yeah, there's some betting machines when we pop through this gate here. We can sell all of our goodies. Yay! And we arrive.
Almost dead? I can fix that.
Sell all the things.
Stay alive out there.
Oh, I found this gun you might want. It's right there.
Seven, forget how to...
Okay, so... Wait, what's that?
I was gonna say, I forget how to heal myself.
I think you have to buy medic, like, stim packs or whatever from the betting machines until you get skill points, which you can spend on stuff that heals. Not sure if the assassin actually has healing.
I made a terrible mistake.
Like I always have to buy stuff.
One more. Oh, you killed him.
Oh, I got him.
Can't thank you enough.
Oh lord.
Let me hit this guy. Let me hit him.
The guy was gonna die.
And out of it. So I think the best thing to do is before we go into the next area where the dude is, we should probably like boost up to like level 5 or something like that. So we could go explore this like right path, which serves no purpose in order to get there, just so we have our special ability. Makes things a lot easier. And I'm down. And I'm up again. Well, this isn't good. I have 18 bolts.
Like how all these games are built.
I'm pretty close to leveling up. I personally love the Unreal Engine. Just from like gameplay perspective. It always feels so smooth. There we go.
A stunning riposte! That sample will do admirably! Find me a few more, if you please.
So yeah, Turbo and I kind of skipped, well, from our recording aspect, we just kind of decided that we were going to try this out. But we kind of decided just to keep going with where we were at in the game.
Instead of doing that.
Currently, so.
Instead of doing that intro stuff with Claptrap, which is super fun.
Yeah, we basically cut out all the exciting stuff, and you're just going to see us running around and doing boring things like killing people. Sucks to be you. Although, if anybody gets to the point in this video, I'll be impressed. And I will slightly question their use of time. Yay, I can now go invisible.
I hate these stupid birds.
I need a sniper rifle. I have one shot left. This is glorious. But in the high life.
I think ammo is such a premium in this game.
Oh my god. You have no idea. But once you get into, like, other areas, it becomes, like, more common than anything. That's really specific, but, yeah.
Ammo's really hard to come by until it's not.
Pretty much. You having fun playing with the parrots? I'm finding so much shotgun ammo, and I don't have a shotgun.
I do.
The struggle. Lucky bastard. I want a shotgun. Mom, can I have a shotgun for Christmas? I want to kill the bandits.
I keep forgetting that ammo is shared in this game.
Yeah, when I was playing this like the first day, I was so afraid of hoarding ammo, and then I found out that everybody had the same amount. I was like, how do you guys sell the ammo? I was taking it all, and they're like, it's shared. And I'm like, oh, fantastic. Back then, I liked being a douche. Making people struggle. Now I just can't avoid it. I have to help people.
Yeah.
There's a bunch of secret loot crates around here that have, may or may not have good guns. I've gotten lucky sometimes and very unlucky. One of which is up here to the left. The shotgun. I have like 100 bullets of shotgun in
Come on, get him. What is next? I don't even know what just happened.
I got you, friend. Stay with me.
No.
I'm alive. That's a good shield.
Really?
Oh.
Don't worry, I won't tell anyone.
God,
shotgun, I found kind of cool.
I think somebody needs to get me an AUG or something.
Wait, who doesn't get that reference? That Counter-Strike Global Offensive of the AUG is like super overpowered right now. Thanks, Baldo.
This is really awesome accuracy update. The AUG awesome, everything else terrible.
Awesome, no matter. Like I have to learn a whole new.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got to help.
The fish that are hanging up in this area all over the place remind me so much of the fish that are in Club Penguin. If you've ever played that. I mean, it was my childhood. So, that's the only reason I know it.
What game?
Club Penguin. It's like a massively multiplayer, I don't know. Really the category. It's just kind of like a child's MMO. Oh, you found one in the boxes. They all suck. Of course.
Yeah, none of them are blue. That's awesome.
There's two more, and they're up here by the boss.
I have 40 health.
Actually, there's three more. There's a health machine inside where the boss spawns, but... Ah, here's some guns. That is a really good pistol.
And there's two really good pistols in here. I'll let you pick first. Since you are the man with the camera. I knew you were gonna pick that one.
I don't even know. Still not good at
touching
the gun. Give me my hit points.
Once you get to know the brand, it becomes a lot easier. Because you know it. I like how you can't revive people when you're reloading. But whatever. Guess it makes sense. And I'm down. And I'm dead.
I was letting you kill him.
Yeah, when you die a certain amount of times, your like timeout thing goes to like a second. Oh, I spawned relatively close to you, so I'm going. Climbing ladder is the most difficult thing in any game. If we kind of avoid these doors, the one of the loot boxes is right here. Some fire guns. Will be helpful. Alright, come on. Dude is a pain in the ass. Also, the midget looks like whatever, you're using on, I'm doing enough. I'm doing like 60.
That was cool!
Well.
Get serious now! Enjoy that.
There's a
this was most helpful to my studies on bullymong social structures. Return to the bounty board at your earliest convenience.
Alright, once we turn this in, maybe we could call this the end of the first episode, and we'll see how everybody likes it or how it turns out.
I'd be really mad if it doesn't pick up my voice. It should, but
a little commentary in the perspective of Turbo. Brought to you by Turbo. Okay. Oh, I have a skill point.
By the way, are you running away? Should we be right to go?
Up to you. I mean, it's activated. But, killing these guys doesn't make later on, like, really easy. At least, like, the next part of the story. This is just a side mission, so... I mean, we're not spoiling much. But... you can expect spoilers if we decide to continue this. Depending on your feedback.
Once you get, like, Puck to watch this, he'll be there.
We're gonna have so many viewers. Like, three.
Yeah.
our revenue will be 1 cent per year.
So it'll do all.
It's enough to fund 6 families.
Yes.
Let's get money. Shiny.
I'm gonna go with just buy shiny. Some Google AdWords or something. That works, right?
Oh. Yeah, I guess. And so all the things.
Was ripped from the hands of dead adventurers. Farewell.
All right.
If you're dead, I'll keep you that way. Good luck. Catch you later.
Stealth.
And back to the southern shelf.
I'm getting about 60 frames recording this, which is pretty good.
Yeah. I think all the things are gonna respawn, but I'm not 100% positive on that. We just run through them. I think they're like level 3, so they'll only give us like 10 XP. This is also very, very early in the game, by the way, so you guys enjoy it, whoever watches this, we can keep going. And we still got the whole game of content to go in front of us.
Hey, free XP for my sentry. Cool.
I do that all the time when I play as a command. I'll just throw it down and let it kill a whole bunch of stuff while I'm, like, selling things. It's wonderful. Alright. I forget what you get from this. I think it's an assault rifle or something? Oh.
Exemplary!
Oh, it's a head. Well, I guess we could see what it looks like real quick while we're still recording, I guess.
Well, I can
There's like a
I could stop the recording and
there's a dude changer over here. Eh, not that big a deal. View our reward. Whoops, I forgot to hit that icon.
Customization station. You can use this to change your appearance and reset your skill points.
Head unlock. I look like a pilot. I look sexy.
I like how you can actually, like, buy heads. Like, pay money for them.
Yeah, they started doing these DLC packs where, like, you can go through the whole DLC and, at the end you get the head customization packs. I'm like, that at least seems like a bit more of a value than just a head.
Yeah. Alright.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pause this recording, or I guess end this one and start the next one, so...